What a deep fireman carry there. See how deep Dan got in there, and then he came right into reverse Nelson and crotch.
And there again, of course, Dan Hodge, American, using the fireman carry, which is a sort of a typical American takedown, and he was good at it. Yes. Jack Briscoe is another very fine fireman carry takedown man.
He got awful deep in here, and here comes the counter, tried to counter it with an overbalance. But notice how he, sort of a wizard type of a hook there, and took him over with a semi-fireman carry.
Right, which
down.
He had set up with the leg dive, and there again, Americans are great leg divers, isn't it? And they're looking, walking into this good old-fashioned American dropkick.
Flying dropkick by Charles that rocked Danny Hodge, and now we're going to see Bob Roop, and again, Tony Charles, an expert with his flying dropkick. Wow! Mind you, now this is just a workout, and yet Bob Roop was shattered by that flying dropkick.
Of course, you know, Gordon, the only way you can get in shape when you're working out is to give it everything you've got, 100%.
Nervous system there. The spinal column there is really being shaken up. There's 33 vertebrae. They're sending out impulses, and the arms and legs just go numb on this type of an attack.
Now it's Harley Race going up against Salento Rodriguez in another, and this one attacks that nervous system too, doesn't it, John?
It certainly does, in the same way. You're hitting it from different directions, though, and it's just not felt in that localized area where you see the impact there in the coccyx area. There, I'm sure the man has got a numbing in his hands and feet, and it's hard to be thinking.
And here's this highly controversial situation with Harley Race that has been declared legal by the NWA. And using his head as a battering ram, coming down against the side of the head of Salento Rodriguez, and this generally spells disaster for any competitor.